Hi everybody. In yesterday's video, I talked a lot about how women deny themselves the opportunities that are present right in front of them. In today's video, I want to continue on the same vein and address a fundamental reason, a very, very common reason that comes up as to why this happens and what to do about it. I'm going to assume that most of the viewers of this video are women, such amazing, talented, intelligent, wonderful women that I come across. I assume that the audience of this video is going to be one of those women. And so I'm going to address this video with a lot of you and not her or them, etc. So if you're a man or a woman who doesn't resonate with this point, feel free to substitute that in your mind with her or them. Now back to the point. The fundamental reason that women do not take up opportunities to speak in meetings or worthwhile interactions, the most common reason that has come up over and over again in the years that I've worked with women executives is because they doubt the value of their point. They doubt if the point or the perspective they want to put forth holds value or will be heard or will be acknowledged. They fear that when they put forth that point, it will be ignored or it might come across as foolish. So you end up thinking that why should I even put it forth, because I'm not really confident about it. So let's hold back and not talk, at least at this point. You see what is fundamentally happening here? You are doubting the worth of your point. You're doubting the worth of your perspective, the value of your perspective. And fundamentally, that comes from a lack of feeling your worth. So you feel your points or your perspective is not worthy because you feel somewhere that you are not worthy, you're not good enough, or you have not worked hard enough, or you're not intelligent enough as the others in the meeting are, or you don't have enough subject matter knowledge to speak about it. So here I want to make a distinction between self-worth and self-confidence. So self-worth is the fundamental basis from which self-confidence emerges. So when you are aware and you stand in the power of your self-worth, knowing what you are, your contributions being valuable, you speak and put yourself forth in the world with confidence. So that's the difference between, at least in my opinion, self-worth and self-confidence. And here in this video, I talk about self-worth because it's the fundamental basis for confidence and all the other great things in your life. Now, in that moment of holding herself back and doubting the worth of her point and herself, her mind is racing. She's overthinking. Her mind races in the fear or overthinking about what all could go wrong. And when she puts forth this point, how it could come across as even foolish or without value, hollow, etc. While instead, what she could actually be thinking is, or she could actually be embodying is the value she holds from all the experiences she's had, all the education she's had, all the interactions she's had, all the experience and knowledge of that subject by having worked in that field with that team, etc. So she could actually embody all that is good about her, bring all her value to that conversation instead of holding herself back. And by bringing her value from her experiences, education, subject matter knowledge, she actually lends a lot of value and credibility to her point, to the meeting, to the organization, to herself. And that is worth a legacy worth living for. Now, it's easy to say, stand in your worth, know your worth, and bring your self-worth to meeting and talk confidently. It's easy to say, I know that. I've been there myself, struggling with all of that. Now, what can be done about it? Here I'm going to use an analogy of a gym. So for example, if you want to build a muscular body, you go to the gym, right? Or you exercise at home, whatever. But it takes consistent, intentional action to build those set of muscles. So it's daily action. It's setting an intention that these are the set of exercises I will do. This is my intention to build a muscular body, and you keep at it every day. So like that, to build that sense of self-worth and self-confidence, you go to the mental gym and go there every day, being intentional at the beginning of the day and throughout the day as much as possible, being aware of your value and exercising that value. So over time, you build that muscle, and most of the actions become automatic and easy to do. Now, I'm going to leave you with 5 steps that you can take to build your sense of worth and speak up in meetings and interactions and bring it to any interaction in your life, be it personal or professional. So, first step is look back at a few interactions in the past, in the recent history, where you've held yourself back from expressing a point, a perspective that you think you want, that you wanted to say, that you wanted to express. Why did you hold back? What happened? What was happening in your physiology? Were you sweating? Were you feeling like a constriction in your throat? Your heart was racing? What was happening? And what were the thoughts in your head? Were you fearful of coming across as looking stupid or not valuable, hollow points, etc.? Write it all down, because this is awareness. Awareness is the first step to taking creative action. So look at all those instances and dump the list of thoughts and feelings and physiological reactions you were having. Write them down and see what comes up. What insights are you having? So this is step one. Step two is, having done step one, not to go into a guilt trip. Cut yourself some slack and be kind to yourself. This is not some airy-fairy bullshit. Being kind to yourself is fundamentally required as a human being. You are, the moment you're kind to yourself is when you will see kindness reflected in your outside world. Being kind to yourself is very important. Self-love and kindness, I cannot stress that enough, because then you will bring out the beauty of your soul when you are a kind person. And by filling your sense, by filling yourself with self-love, you reflect that out into the world. The other reason is, when you are in the, mired in the feelings of guilt and being, feeling not so good about yourself, you're not gonna think and act from the energy of possibilities, opportunities, curiosity, growth and learning. So to be able to grow and develop in life, you need to be actually standing from the bedrock of kindness and possibilities. So there is no space for guilt and resentment at that point. That's step two. So let's rewind. Step one is look back at all those instances where you have held yourself back. Step two is, having taken that list in mind, be kind to yourself. And now step three is swimming in that sea of self-love and kindness from step two. Again, list down 10 to 30 things that are awesome about yourself. Some things that you're good at, something that's great about you. It's about your personality, about your skills at work, about your skills as a person, everything. And don't be ashamed. This list is for you. Nobody else is going to watch it, at least not yet, if you don't want it. So be shameless and write everything that you love about yourself. In the beginning, you might struggle to even come up with 3 or 5 probably, but over time, you'll build that list and put it in a place where you'll see it. It's gonna be an important tool for you going forward in life. That's step three. Step four is, set an intention. Set an intention that you, from today on, from this moment on, are going to bring your full, complete, valuable self, replete with all these gifts that you've just listed down, in your complete energy as a powerful, worthy woman. You know, any interaction, you bring that powerful self into any meeting, any interaction, personal or professional, you're gonna play big in your life, because you're worthy and you have so many gifts to share with the world. That's step four, set an intention. Step five is gonna be simple, because you've done steps 1 to 4. Go do it. It would take stepping out of the comfort zone, because anything that's worth doing in life needs you to step out of your comfort zone. And the more you do it, it becomes your new normal. So step outside of your comfort zone and build that mental muscle and just do it. So that's my message for the day. These are five solid steps that I myself follow in my daily life. And I hope that helps you. Please leave me your comments, and I'm really interested in hearing them. Thank you for staying with me, and bye for now.